All right, round five. We have Joe back on camera again with Teamer Midrange, still undefeated, versus Josh Campbell with Bug Delirium. Very interesting deck, something we really don't see a whole lot in Modern. But, I mean, he's doing pretty well with it, so... Checking their sevens.
First off, can that other guy even see him? Yes. On the second floor?
Yes.
Really?
Yep.
Rulor's on
target. Looks like both sevens are good, and we are going to start off with a Fetch Thoughtseize. Showing that Joe has a hand of four lands, one Blood Moon, one Ancestral Visions, one Roast. Now this pick with Thoughtseize is very interesting. It's really based on however Josh's hand is set up. If he can fetch around the Blood Moon, then he definitely doesn't want to take that. If he has like a Termagoyf that he wants to resolve, the Roast is probably the pick. Or if he thinks Raw Card Advantager is going to be the real deciding factor in this matchup, then he takes the Visions. If he thinks Raw Card Advantage, it is. Oh my, Joe top decks a Goblin Dark Dwellers. That's quite good. It's gonna allow him to flashback that Visions for free. Fetch. Goes out of 16.
And then a D3 pressure tail catch. Oh shit. Before I even do that.
Gonna take two. Down to 14. Play out a Jace. Oh. Very interesting. It's a card that saw some initial hype when it first released, but after the pact, people started to doubt its validity. It just wasn't quite good enough. It was very good when Twin was still legal, but it kind of fell off since then. Still just powerful enough for Modern, though. Joe fetching an island, very aware that he is going to be slamming a Blood Moon on turn 3. Top deck's land. Shuck. Roast. Does not want that Jace to get active or get online at all. Currently we have sorcery land creature in the yard. Not quite enough to fire this traverse for a creature. Tribal Instant? Cantrips into Traverse. Oh, that's an Architects of Will, isn't it? Interesting. Essentially using it as a four mana 3/3 that, looks at the top three cards of your opponent's library, or your library, or a one mana cantrip. Both sides valid. Wait, just the battle of the spicy brews here today. Interesting. Fetches up a green untapped green source. so that he can still play his spells under Blood Moon. He's going to be locked out of blue for the moment during this Blood Moon. He'll still have access to green.
Now it's my turn.
Question is, does he... Nope, he does not want to fire this Blood Moon off right now. He wants to just sit back, holding onto a mana leak. Are we going to try to catch whatever play? Goes to 12. Plays a Liliana, and that Liliana is going to get mana leaked.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Fetches. It's going to go for a basic, I believe. Yes. Goes for basic island. Wants to have access to as much as blue as possible after the Blood Moon resolved. Joe's turn. And Taps plays a what looks like a wooded foothills. Now he is thinking about his line here. He could fetch for a green source and play this Blood Moon, or he could just play the Blood Moon out in order to cast a turn 5 Goblin Dark Dwellers. So it's all a matter of, does he want to prioritize holding on to green, or does he want to assure that he will cast the Dark Dwellers? I think he wants to cast that Dark Dwellers, it looks like. Which is completely understandable, because the raw card advantage that creates is just absolutely where you want to be in these mid-range matchups. Oh, he shocks. Is it 13? Now he's going to slam his Blood Moon. His opponent cracks in response. Goes for, I believe, a basic island. Yep, so now his opponent has access to all three colors under the Blood Moon. His mana is obviously very restricted now, but he is not locked out. Back to Josh. Josh draws a card. Finds another land. Just not great. Looks like he has a land Jace. Doesn't want to play out the Jace. Fourth land, had the green source. Thinking about hard casting this here, Dark Dwellers, just slamming it on 5. And he says, yes, I will do that. I will draw 3 cards. 3 in, exile, pass the turn. Josh not looking good here. Chose very far ahead. Goes for the draw, finds another island, and slams for 4. Puts his opponent down to 7. Puts a vision on suspend and passes. Forest into ooze. Gets spell snared. Untap, tick down, draw a card. Finds the bolt, so that should be lethal. attack. Put you to 3. Bolt you. Next game. Joe has been just been absolutely destroying this tournament so far. Every time we show this deck, every time I've looked at this deck or walked past this deck playing, it just looks so powerful against everything in the room. Blood Moon is still a house, especially when you can still interact with your opponent with blue spells. Both players going to bring in a number of grindy cards for this matchup to try to trump the other's plans. Things like Thrag Tusk and Thrun and more Lilianas, more Thoughtseize effects. Actually, no. I don't know. Thoughtseize effect is pretty good here because it's a blue-based control deck. So I was going to say initially, usually in the mid-range Thoughtseize matchups, you take out your Thoughtseize and Inquisitions because they're bad top decks late. But it might be a little different considering Joe is on a blue-based deck with things like Cryptic Command and Spell Snare and Mana Leak. You might want to be able to top deck a Inquisition or a Thoughtseize late game to just strip one of those cards out of Joe's hand. So it's probably just right to side them out. Just go with every card in your deck being proactive. And just being some kind of threat that grinds value. Rather quick game for a mid-range matchup. I will give it that. Usually these games grind out into the 20-30 minute range. Very interesting. I think I see a Shriek Maw on the bottom of his deck. I'm sure Josh is playing a number of spicy one-ofs in order to dig up with his Traverse. Now, what else would you really want in a Traverse deck? It's either you're playing Traverse as copies 1 through 5 through 8 of your Death Shadow, or you're playing Traverse as copies 2, 3, 4, and 5 of any given one of in your deck. Something very interesting that I've noticed in the room is there's very little Death Shadow. The last few months of the Titanium series, there has been just nothing but Death Shadow, wall to wall. I think the meta has finally adapted to the point where people are all on decks to beat Shadow, or that have favorable Shadow matchups, and those people were previously playing Shadow, so there's just no one for them to fight. So they're just fighting amongst each other, just collecting company decks, battling it out. But we have not seen company yet, strangely enough. Ooh, an Ishkan in Modern. Oh, man. Josh, I love your deck. I love me some Ishkan, huh? That resolved, it's a absolute beating. Both players on their sevens. Quick fetch from Josh.
Two of those, but you have four. I dealt two, but then I did the sixes on the things that went through.
Ooh, is that an Emrakul in his hand? I think that's an Emrakul of the Promised End. My god, he's just playing, like, the green-black Delirium deck from two standards ago with blue in Modern. This is wild. Turn two, Tarmogoyf. From Josh. So you think fetch up another basic as well? It's gonna play around that moon. Weirdly enough, as Joe said on camera though, there's only one moon in the main. So he has been pretty good at consistently drawing his one of moon. I believe he has moons in hand though. See, he does side some in. Plays land. Tarmogoyf is a 1/2 right now. So a bolt would kill it. Joe looking at more moons in hand. I believe that's an Eternal Witness in Josh's hand as well. Land. Two attacks. So going for the fetch for the basic forest. Snap. Can I get you? Fatal push. Another fetch out of Joe. Gotta say another basic. Looks like it is probably time for the moon. I think that was also a Bajuka Bog? Out of Josh? A tapped Bajuka Bog? Which, this Blood Moon is pretty good against him. As we saw Joe exiled his graveyard. Yeah, there was a Bajuka Bog. Wow. That's pretty spicy. Fulminator Mage. Pop your non-basic attack. Hit you for 3. Basic. Pass a turn. Currently, Josh on instant land creature. So not yet to the required for Ishkana's delirium ability. Joe plays another basic. Passes the turn. Josh finds a land. The question is, would he want to just raw dog a 3/5? I don't think so, but plays a snap. A raw snap blocks. Just fog, essentially. Joe plays a mountain. Traverse. No delirium. Josh goes and finds another basic. Probably another basic forest in order to now cast his Ishkana with Delirium. Oh, he does not. He's going to probably set up for the next turn. Plays his own Goyf. Pass back, Fatal Push the Goyf. I believe that's game. Yep, that is game.
That sucks.
Alright, going to game three with Joe on the play. Ishkana was not cast, unfortunately. Definitely the most interesting matchup we've seen all day. Two decks that really aren't meta decks, aren't decks that you would see generally in a the 4-0 area of a league online, but they are here today and they are absolutely crushing it. In their sevens. What if Foothills pass for Joe? Back on the other side. Josh thinking about his plays. What land to play first? That is the question. Plays a basic into a traverse. Finds another basic. Oh, not a basic. Plays a overgrown tomb into a traverse. Finds another basic to play around the Blood Moon. Joe untaps. Plays a Termagoyf on turn two. It's a 2-3 Termagoyf. Of course, Josh has plenty of Fatal Pushes in his deck, so Termagoyf is not an impossible creature to beat. Ooh, Joe with another Termagoyf in hand. That's quite good. And a Blood Moon. Saucy. Smashes for two. Puts Josh down to 16. Joe with the fetch. Down to 18. Grab another basic and play another Termagoyf. In this case, game is looking much better for Joe. Double Termagoyf and a Vision Suspended. Down to 15 for Josh. Also Joe with a Chandra in hand, and I believe another Goyf. That's ridiculous. Oh, his opponent fetching a non-basic after not seeing a Blood Moon that turn. Bold play, Cotton. See if it works out. Corso Crucifix. Tick down. That Goyf is untapped. Blood Moon. Attacks with his 2-3 Goyfs. Gets in 2 damage. Puts Josh down to 13. Josh gains 1 life, goes up to 14, and exiles Joe's graveyard. So Josh now on only 1 green mana. Ooh, gets rid of that Blood Moon. It's what looks like a Reclamation Sage. I want to say it's a Reclamation Sage. Glares a little bad on it. Takes that down, draws a card. Turn voice now 3/4 because of the enchantment. That's. Yep, there's Reclamation Sage. Reclamation Sage dies. Turn voice become 4 power. I want to say. Josh gaining a small amount of life from his courser. No, I think this Blood Moon might lock him out of the game. Right, so he has a Fulminator Mage, which is going to get mana leaked. Putting up the Termagoyfs to 4. It's land, sorcery, instant, creature, enchantment. Oh, no, 5s. Turn goes around 5s. Which presents a very quick clock. Ooh, a roast as well. That's brutal. Puts his opponent 2-1. Don't think there's an out in Josh's deck. Actually, no, there is. The Blood Moon's not in play, so. Oh, wow. That's saucy. Big game hunter. Big Game Hunter, very interesting card. It has Madness for 1 black. It's a discard. If you Madness it, or when you cast it, it's destroy target creature with power 4 or greater. Though Joe is about to draw 3 cards, so I have a feeling that he will find the answer here. Untap. Visions. Draw four. Does not find an answer immediately. You could see your visions to try to find it. Joe takes one. Goes to 17. Finds another island. Snapcaster? Oh, yep, no, that's it. Snap removal spell, kill you. If Josh does not have an answer, that is. Roast there, six you. So said, Lily? Really? I think Joe forgot what life totals were there for a second. I'm the one that is wrong. I haven't been keeping track of life totals correctly. Something probably has to be fixed. Liliana, kill your Snapcaster. The turn. All Joe has to do here is attack him and protect his Goyf. Joe at 16. Goes to 14. Because he has Logic Knot in hand. Double bottom with Seer Visions. Attack you with Thermowave. We're up to K. Ooh, that doesn't work. Oh no. Oh no. Cannot Logic Knot that. Right. Plays another Thermowave though. Ships it back. Josh has just, at every turn I have thought Josh was just out of this game, but he has found a way back in. Joe thinking about the Logic Knot on this traverse. Though I do not think it is correct to Logic Knot here. Just Logic Knot the threat that it grabs. Because currently Josh is staring at a Thrag Tusk that would gum this board up considerably. Another judge call. Man, Joe's matches have a lot of judge calls. I'll say that. Well, while we wait for this judge call to resolve, we can talk about the Challenge series. What you are currently watching is a series that happens at TGA Collectibles in Milford every month. Once every month, we do a 1K, at least 1K, that scales up in prizing based on the number of attendees. This month, we have $1,600 in prizing across Top 16 because we hit 82 players. The largest TJ Titanium series yet. And let me tell you, we are stuffed in here. There are a lot of people in this basement right now. Joe deciding to lodge not the traverse, which is unwise, unfortunately. So now the path is clear for this Thrag Tusk. Oh, he's just gonna tick down the lily. See what he finds. He's got a Goyf, he's got a Rexage, he's got a Fulminator Mage. He's going to choose the Big Game Hunter. Kill your Termagoyf. Pass turn. Jaunteps, Drezzard. Found a land. Plays a land. Pass turn. Unfortunately, Joe is staring at a handful of lands right now. It's not looking good for him. Slams a Thrag Tusk. Slag Tusk plus Liliana is just... that's just value for days. Kill your Thrag Tusk? Oh, get my Thrag Tusk back. Slams him for 2. So the 13. So 12. Which his fetch puts him to 11. And 11 on Josh's side from that Thrag Tusk. 11 all. Finds a Spell Snare. Definitely not where he wants to be. Josh untaps, draws. To play a Tireless Tracker. Play a Fetch Land, get a Clue. Oof. This is brutal. For 7. Let's go down to 4. Or 5. I think they might have missed a fetch somewhere. Joe's top deck here has to be something very powerful, or this game is going to be locked up. And Visions. Oh, that's a start. Cast Visions. Draws an island, and that should do it, unfortunately. Alright, Josh Campbell advances to 5-0 and locks himself up for top 8. Unfortunate for Joe, but he still has a chance. All he needs to do is win his next round, and then he has the chance to draw in as long as his breakers are good. So, definitely not out of it. Alright, so that was round 5. we will see you again in the next round, where we will start playing, having some people on camera that are fighting tooth and nail for top 8.